Hey everybody, so today is a beautiful day. I'm hoping that that the fish are still there from the other day. And the objective today was tuna. We'd like to try to get out there and see if we can get some tuna, make some poke bowls, and have some sushi. So I'm excited about that. Wind is just kind of too bad, kind of hazy and overcast. That might make it for a great fishing day. So I'm gonna go out there, use some ballyhoo, use some trolling feathers, and try to find some birds and some weed lines, and do it all again. Only just a couple of tuna would be great, mixed in with maybe a mahi, and as a bonus, a wahoo would be awesome. So follow me, and let's go head out. All right, so headed out through Adams Cut and into Largo Bay. Out. We got into about the same amount of water. I'm at 304 right now. No indication of fish out there. Put the feather out before I had a chance to put out the second rod. Boom, we got whacked. So, not sure what it is, of course, but we'll find out. Pokey bowls tonight. There we go. It's a little black fin. Perfect size. Ah, fabulous. Alright, I gotta do the bad part, which is bleed them out. Up the blood a little bit, put them back out. I guess I didn't even have a chance to deploy any other rods. I was like, boom. Thank you. got a small planer with a Islander on it and a Ballyhoo. And then a Ballyhoo on the other side up near the top. Coming up against some reed lines over here. So maybe we're going to get lucky here.
Birds. I see reed lines.
they almost beat themselves to death. So I got the rag on, just sort of calm them down because they get crazy, man. Look at this. Come on. The small planer out. I haven't got a hit on it over here yet, but I'm hoping that if anything does hit it, it'll be a little bigger. Joke be on me. This fight all day though. Season right now, so regrettably gonna have to go back. The funny part is it got hooked on my swivel and not even the hook. So don't figure. Damn, I was excited there for a minute. Alright, back to putting out these lines. Thank you. bass. I mean, I can't even tell you how excited I am. This guy is huge. So the blood and guts left over. There's actually a drop of blood on the end of the gaff. I think that might be the cover of this. So still tangled up with the other rod, and blood and guts everywhere. Absolutely well worth the whole thing. Let's check this out. Yeah, there he is. He's in there. He's got to be probably 25, maybe almost 30. He's a beautiful, beautiful fish. We'll get some pictures of him when we get back. So, awesome day. End of the day, believe it or not. End of the day in 200 feet of water is where this fish was. So I'm just going to attempt to clean this mess up. If you will, with this size hook, which is completely bent by the way, and then some 30 pounds of line. So, and all the other habits and ends and all the heavy hitting rods, this is the one that he decided to hit. So, I was hoping to get like something like this on the habit. Bad. At least it didn't look like we had a whole bunch of problems on board today. There's the phone. More than likely. It is Elizabeth. We pretty much got most of the blood cleaned up. Draining out some of it out of the cooler right now. Just to kind of get us back. Keep the fish from getting all totally beat up, so I'm running some of that water out of there. Nice and iced down by the time I get them back, take some pictures, and then fillet them up. So one more look, gotta do it. Oh my god! All right, absolutely outstanding. Yeah, I got another problem over there too. So that's gonna make some awesome steak. Amazing. All right, man, he's so smooth, just so beautiful. Just an awesome fish. Absolutely amazing. Just gorgeous colors. It's incredible. Alright, when we get back, we'll take some good pictures. Time to head back.
Life is good.